Hi everybody, today we're going to tie on some Pro Sport Fisher stuff and we're going to make a winterized hope. And what we're going to do is get that large hook guide, it's a large flexi needle, and to that I'm going to put a large hook guide. For this fly, you could go with either fluorescent yellow or fluorescent orange. Both work great for a winter's hope color scheme. And winter's hope flies are something that I've always liked fishing with. I haven't had a ton of success with them, but the color combination is great, so I just kind of turned it into an intruder. And here we go. The small one at that, it's very easy to cast. You can easily use this on a Scandinavian line as well as your Skagit lines and sink tips. Okay, so start with some 6-aught thread. So what we're going to be using today is some of this American Opossum. This is a Pro Sport Fisher product. Today we're going to be using hot yellow on the back end with the orange and then cyan blue on the front end with the purple. And what I've done, this comes in about a 5.5 by 5.5 inch square. I've just straight cut a piece of it. You can see that the leather's ground. If you want to use it in strip fashion, it doesn't hold a bunch of water. It's very nice to cast. But we're going to put it in a dubbing loop. So all I'm going to do is prep this and pull a little piece off. That's probably more than I need, actually. This hair is amazingly densely packed. So from here for a dubbing loop, we're going to set that down and prep a dubbing loop. This is a hairline spinner. I don't know, 16 or 17 bucks. These are, if you do a lot of dubbing loops, these are worth owning. Okay, so the dubbing loop's made, but it's kind of wide up at the top and I want to pinch that closed. So I'm going to put two wraps around the dubbing loop itself and then pinch that off with a couple of wraps. Now the top of that dubbing loop's tight and will hold the hair very nicely. Okay, so now to prep this guy, all I like to do is take the leather, fold it in half lengthwise. This may be just a hair out of focus. Okay. So once that's folded in half, then I can straighten out all the hair, switch hands, and it's very easy to cut off the leather. There we go. Open the dubbing loop, slide in our opossum. It's pretty key for these dubbing loops to get the hair as close to 90 degrees from the actual dubbing loop so it doesn't bind on itself. And it's pretty dense, so I want to just spread this stuff out a ways here. The actual butts are gonna actually help prop the tips. So I just am shortening them just because I want a little more length in the possum. And when we think we're good, just spin her up. Hopefully it comes through pretty handy. I just want to make sure that nothing gets bound, which it actually looked really good. And tighten the dubbing loop up a little bit. You'll definitely know when your dubbing loop's too tight, as it'll break the thread. So a little bit of practicing with that, and you'll have it. Okay, to make that a little bit simpler, I've just added a hackle plier, taking off the dubbing loop twister. One, full turn, two full turns, and I'm just putting one successfully in front of the next. On the back end, I wouldn't mind this to be a little bit shallower profile. On the front end, I want a bigger profile. So I'm not packing these wraps super, super tightly together. Just put one in front of the next until you feel like you got enough on there. This is probably going to be 4 to 5 turns, and that looks like plenty of hair. A couple of turns out. Bend that hair back. Few thread wraps will lock everything down. That's going to be bulletproof. Okay, now while you're spinning, you may find that some of the fibers are trapped and it's not going to swim as good. So just run that flea comb or whatever you have to blast that out. That looks great. Okay, the next is going to be the orange marabou, and this is going to be very light just to fill it in. I want something just a little bit longer than the possum. So I'm actually going to strip most of the stuff off of here and just get up to the short stuff on by the tips. So as you prep that, some of those off. And I want this marabou to be really sparse. Okay, so I've got my marabou prepped. I'm gonna turn that in tip first. Lock that in place and we'll put a couple turns on it. All right, so we've got the marabou tied in tip first and ready to go. And I'm just gonna sweep. Try to leave a nice handle on there too. These things tend to want to spin. By gently sweeping the fibers as you're wrapping. Pull those up and around. There's one spin. Second spin of marabou. I'll probably bring it up over the top. Maybe 2.5 turns of marabou is all we really need. And then clip that guy out. When you guys are putting these together, I think intruder is a pretty loosely termed fly. Anything big these days is called intruders. I mean, that's obviously like a Jerry French Ed Ward thing, but this is just a bigger fly. And what I'm really trying to create is something that's got movement and is a little bit larger than a standard harrowing fly. So the possum's at one length, the marabou's at the next length. We're gonna put some ostrich over the top of it, which is gonna do a couple of things. One is the water's gonna grab it and help right the fly. And then we can layer in another length so that once the fly's wet, it doesn't clump. Clumping bad. So maybe 7 or 8 pieces or so. This is a ostrich that Montana Fly Company offers. Very high quality. It's almost like it's kind of poor man's rhea. So that'll be a little bit longer. Measure that off. And just take your thumb and forefinger and we'll splay those out a little bit. So that goes from 90 degrees my side over to the top. And we'll do 7 more on the other side. These aren't really locking wraps, just a couple placing wraps to hold them so you can get in there. You don't have to spin the vise. Your thumb and forefinger and splay that out. Perfect. And this will actually help it even look like it's almost hackle. So I'm gonna hold those snug, unwrap everything, loose wrap, one forward, go back, forward. Now we've locked those things in place. There we go, we've got 180 degrees of ostrich going around there. Okay, so now I'm gonna advance the thread, and we're just using a silver mylar here. So I do want a thread base on the tube so it stays put. If you want further durability, even zap a gap and down, you can do that if you'd like. That point, and this is when I like to install the weight. I'm going to use a raw weight on the front end. A little dot of zappa gap on there. This is a Pro Sport Fisher raw weight. The size is small. These things are very, very dense and get flies to break the surface tension really easily. Smalls and mediums tend to be the most popular. That's in place. And that's just going to hold it in place with the zappa gap so as I'm working the body, this doesn't inadvertently move forward and mess up my proportions of the fly. The next thing we're using is a number 10 mylar tensile. We'll just get a little bit of that off of here. Traditional body color for a winter's hope. Silver side down, so as I flip it over, it shows the silver side. Tight snug wraps. For the next, it's just a nice orange steelhead dubbing. This is Fish Dope, sun-kissed orange. Just gonna cover up that tie-out point with just a bit of dubbing. Okay, now instead of flaring deer hair or a chenille ball with slopping, this is how I'm going to get the prop. This is a soft sonic disc, and it's just made of plastic. It's got vented holes in it, so water moves through it. It's easy to cast, and this is a size medium. You could also go size large if you want a little bit bigger profile. We're going to do another dubbing loop on the front and kind of recreate what we did on the back end, but with the purple and blue. And this is a cyan blue possum, same thing. Turn that over. Clip the piece. Bend that in the thumb and forefinger. Straighten the hair and cut the leather off. Cyan blue is really nice long stuff. I just got lucky with this piece of hair. Okay, it looks like it's ready to go. Nice to have this flea comb as well, or a dubbing teaser, because once you can get in there and work through it and it doesn't come out, you know you're locked in. There we go. And these I'm going to pack a little more densely right on top of each other than the back end. Want the front end of the fly to have some shoulders. Be proud. Same thing as the last one, I just want to get in there. Free up that possum. That's good. Now, at this point, you can either go with another Kingfisher or Silver Doctor Blue. I like the just a real sparse purple marabou, and then we'll use some purple ostrich. Again, I'm going to get rid of most of the long stuff on here. Thank you. maybe 2.5 turns or so. A couple pieces of flash we're going to use, a crinkle mirror flash, Cascade Crest, Fish Hunter. A few different companies make it. I believe it's the same material. Just going to throw a couple pieces in. Now we'll go 360 degrees around with some purple ostrich, and that'll get that effect of the blue and purple and the winter's hope. Length measure that so it's a little longer than the ostrich, not as long as the stuff on the back. I'm going with 7 strands or so. And I'll do side, top, side, and bottom. Do the far side, just find it easier to flip the needle over. And the last clump of 7. Same thing we do on the back end. I'm going to unwrap everything. And a very soft wrap. There we go. Now it's locked in well. It almost looks like it was put on by, through a Hackland. Some of these little ostrich pieces you may want to get out of here. Lightly tease those out with a razor blade. Okay, a little purple flopping. Take a lot of the force of the water rushing up against it and free the ostrich to move. three, about three full turns of slopping. Okay, a couple turns of purple guinea and a couple pieces of JC and we'll be ready to fish. We're gonna use a Pro JC, and this is size medium in cyan blue. And these are actually kind of witness cut already. All I have to do is get up to the tab on the top, make a trim cut. Open those up, slide the scissors down to the bottom. One. Two. And those might square off a little bit when you take them out, so just going in there and gently. Once you clip it out, you may have squared off the top of it, so just get in there with your scissors and make real light cuts. You have that nice round curve over there. Just about three turns. I'm going to go ahead and flip that needle upside down for the opposite side. Together, this will actually do a little zapping out trick here. I'm just going to run that zap down the length of the tying thread. Now to lock in the JC, give it a nice shiny finish like you did two-part epoxy. So while that zapper gap's drying, I'm gonna go in with a razor blade and cut out those little jungle clock tabs. There's one. Roll the vise a little bit so we can see what you're doing. There we go. Check the thread, it's all dry, ready to go. There we go, Pro Sport Fisher winterized hope. The last move I'm going to make is just cut this really thin and do a little heat burnish here. I just want to leave a millimeter or so. I'm going to slide the tube and hook guide. Off the needle. I'll try to do this so you guys can see it. What we want is a really short cut. Don't want to leave a lot of extra plastic on there to burn and melt and close the tube. Super short, even if you're holding on a metal cone or a plastic cone for some weight. So I've got that real short cut. I just hold it vertical, start the heat source. And just roll the lip, leaves the hole open. That'll fit till 15, 10 pound maximum, whatever you like to fish with as a tippet. There you go. Winterized hope.